now we're going to hear from Peter Weispfenning of the Marxist-Leninist Party of Germany, MLPD.
Yes, hello, friends, comrades. I talked to Connie. Can I talk in German? She said it's no problem, but it would be only understand from the Germans. And so I try to talk in English, but so I have to read my statement. And my English is not so good as the English from Rainer or from Joma, so I'm not so spontaneous and not so poetic, I'm afraid, but I try my very best. It's a great pleasure for me to be able to say a few words of appreciation for the current book by José María Sison, Reflections on Revolution and Prospects, and the German version. It's Ein Leben im Widerstand, Gespräche über Imperialismus, Sozialismus und Befreiung. It's remarkable that the book was published almost simultaneously in English and German. Of course, this has something to do with the person of the interviewer, Rainer Werning. Yes, he is a profound German Southeast Asian expert. But he doesn't do this on an academic level, but out of a felt and lived solidarity with the revolutionary struggle in the Philippines. He is also on the board of the German Philippine Friends. Thanks also go to the competent and fast team of translators, Rick and Gisela De Lori, the two leading translators are here this evening as well. And then Rainer said he had a very, wie sagt Rainer, wie sagt man das? Der Heinz.
We had a very stimulating editor as well.
Yes.
who is well versed in the German tongue. Yes.
Yeah. Writing good German is not so easy.
And deep translation.
But I believe that the German-Filipino friendship, meaning of course the friendship of the German with the Filipino people, the revolutionaries in Germany and in the Philippines, is something special. We were very happy that we were able to publish the book by Joma Sison in our publishing house Neuer Weg. For the MLPD, I can definitely say that everything that Joma Sison says is not a statement of some revolutionary, which of course would be significant too, but always meets special interest of our comrades. The book presents Joma Sison in excellent form and at the cutting edge of the times, as you have seen this evening. It is therefore also a defeat for the anti-communist agitators who warned about an aloof Joma Sison retired in the Dutch exile. This asylum is hard won, as the book shows. And of course, he does not go to the Philippines without security guarantees against Duterte's fascist death squads. And as a German, I say Marx and Engels too had to spend the longest period of their revolutionary work in English exile, and yet they were closely linked to the German working class. No matter where you live, it is primarily a question of the mode of thinking, whether you are closely connected with the class struggle internationally and in your country of origin. Joma Sison shows himself in this book as a multifaceted as he is as a personality. As a Marxist-Leninist theorist, as a fervent revolutionary, a leader of the Philippine Workers and People's Movement, as an internationalist, as a diplomat, as a poet, and as a humorous, cheerful and optimistic person. The book is the eagerly awaited sequel to Rainer Werning's earlier interview series of 1988, The Philippine Revolution, The Leader's View. The 10 chapters and the numerous questions assigned to each of them appear like a tour d'horizon, through the turbulent times since 1989, across the most diverse continents and into the most diverse subject areas. But it's not like many books, just the interview partner says anything he just feels or things like that, but it's also a profound analysis. It's very short, you see a short question, short answer, so you can read it in a good way, but it's not Juba didn't think it in the second, but he worked very long years to get to these conclusions. So be aware if you study it and think, oh, Juba has a nice idea. It's not a nice idea by the moment, but it's from a Marxist-Leninist approach. What I see as certain basic lines in the books are the following points. A thoroughgoing critique of modern revisionism and the restoration of capitalism in the former socialist countries. He continues Mao Zedong's analysis of the importance of ideological struggle and rights. Quote, at first, the petty bourgeoisie mode of thinking arose and spread among the new intelligentsia and bureaucracy in the ruling party, the economy and various institutions. In due course, the new bourgeoisie became a reality bred by selfish impulse of the intelligentsia and the bureaucratics, the acquisition of privileges and the influence of the international bourgeoisie. Quote end. And this is not mainly a historical question, because if you want to win the masses for socialism again, you have to answer what happened wrong. Otherwise, you will never win the masses for socialism in these times. So these historical items are very important for the discussion today. Next point. The analysis of the far-reaching changes in imperialism since 1989. The author examines the emergence and advancement of new great imperialist powers, China and Russia. He confronts the faith healers of imperialism with the analysis of a deepening crisis of imperialism on a wide range of issues. The environmental question, the intensified threat of war, the increasing exploitation of the developed dependent countries, and so on. He also sheds light on the international danger of fascism, which has taken concrete shape with Duterte as a leader of a proto-fascist government in the Philippines. Even in Germany, where the ruling class still adhere to the system of petty bourgeois mode of thinking as the main method of government, we are experiencing an acute fascist tendency. To the question of the friend, we have two important tendencies in Germany. The one is a very hard right development of government, bourgeois parties in the media, in the culture, and under a part of the masses. It's a right tendency. And we have even a fascist tendency with this new in Germany after Second World War. But we have also a tendency of progressive changing in the thoughts of the German person. So in this year we had 4 million Germans on the streets. You will not have heard it in the Netherlands as well. It's not so big in the media, but this is the biggest demonstrations since 2003, as the demonstrations against Iraq war was. So this is there are both two tendencies, and we have a big polarization between reactionary lines and progressive lines, and it's we try hard to have a leading position or get a leading position. It's different in the Philippines, but at a point the same maybe. You can tell it better. The third point, in which I think is very important, is the quintessence on page 143 in German. Quote, we are on the eve of a new upsurge of revolutionary struggle worldwide. Quote end. And this is absolutely correct, but it's not, you will find very much leaders of the left who say, oh, it's a dark situation, and everything is bad, and no one wants to fight. This is not the reality. It's an optimistic book, and we need optimistic books. The international workers and Marxist-Leninist movement has passed through the deep valley of defeat by revisionism and it is making noticeable progress. Zuma Sison has made an important contribution to this in his leading work in the ICMLPO and is a long-standing chairman of the ILPS. And he is now has now an important role working together from ILPS and ICOR to set up steps for building up an anti-imperialist united front. This is on worldwide level, I think, one of the most important things which has to build. What I also like, Sison is not a revolutionary romantic. He's romantic, but not a revolutionary romantic. Maybe he's romantic.
How do you know?
Maybe. He combines his deep confidence in victory with a critical and self-critical approach. For example, he pointed out in the book that it had already been expected several times that a strategic stalemate in the Philippines would be reached, which for various reasons did not yet happen. The way to national and social liberation is just full of twists and turns, and who, in contrast to Joma, claims to know everything up front and had nothing to learn, should apply for the papacy in Rome and not want to be the leader of the revolutionary movement. This is not Joma. Joma is criticism and self-criticism. This is very important. And last but not least, I see the book as an offer for further discussion of the questions that have been raised. The very worst, apart from the revisionists, are the dogmatists, who in any case expect nothing new from the world under the sun or since Lenin's death. We will gladly take up this offer of discussion and will continue to discuss with him in a stimulating way about far-reaching questions like the emergence of new imperialist countries, changes in the superstructure of the imperialist world system, the role of international industrial proletariat, and so on. We will not discuss it yet, but this is, I think, very important for the persons from other countries that we read it and then we discuss and bring our ideas, and so we get steps forward. Of course, the book deals in particular with the development in the Philippines. This is fundamental for anyone who wants to show solidarity with the Philippines. I cannot organize effective solidarity if I myself do not know what is happening in the country, what the actors represent, how the revolution is developing, and so on. This is another reason why this book is a must for every progressive person who wants to develop solidarity with the Philippine people, or, what is even more, the mutual solidarity of the peoples and the labor movement of the world. It highlights important changes in the Philippines. Thus, the author proves that the US still has the main imperialist influence in the Philippines politically. But he also examines how Chinese new imperialism is penetrating the Philippines more and more economically, which is connected with military aggression and, of course, also with political influence. Joma Sison does not side with any imperialist, but stands up for a consistent anti-imperialist standpoint. And this, you say, yes, of course, but there's a big chaos. The German revisionist party says we have to go with China and with Russia to defeat the imperialism. They are no imperialists, they are not good, but objective, they are anti-imperialists, and then you get absolutely chaos in strategy and tactics. You have to fight against all imperialism, as Joma tells us. The book gives new insights into the current development of the Philippine revolutionary movement. It defends the right to revolutionary struggle and proves that the CPP has never bowed to imperialism but has stuck to the revolutionary line for 51 years. One thing is certain, the development will continue and raise new questions. So this book will continue in one way or another by Joma Sison. Maybe not with the third book, but in another way. What better thing can you say about a book if you are already looking forward to its continuation? But first of all, you should buy and read this book. Thank you.
Very good advertisement, Peter.